So we basically thought that we'll combine the sustainability and transportation into a single group and maybe focus on perhaps sustainable transportation. So what we thought was, we had some brainstorming yesterday and also today. We thought, let's see if we can kind of bring out some high-level research questions which can kind of frame this particular activity. So the first one is actually related to a kind of a meta question. How do you answer questions related to various aspects of transportation? So you want to do a lot of what if type things, you know. For example, the BBMP has been wondering about introducing guided small taxi corridors, right, as feeder services. So is it useful? They want to know, like, should we put that in? You know, should their steel flyover be constructed? Of course, they didn't ask us, but maybe we should ask such questions. For example, BMTC and KSRTC is interested to know if what is the impact of moving from diesel to CNG for the buses. You know, so that kind of brings to this connection between traffic and pollution. You know, what if the amount of there is some independent data which actually says that for cities like Bangalore, traffic does contribute a significant fraction of the pollution in Bangalore, unlike say in Delhi or something where there are some other sources which dominate. Also, there are other stakeholders who would be interested to know the impact of micro events. You know, road digging happens, or there is some VIP movement, and so on. You know, both for planning as well as in real time, what is the impact, and being able to communicate it to the people. There are aspects, for example, in Bombay, there is a question which Professor Kriti mentioned about. They're trying to figure out where to actually place the emergency response providers, like fire stations. Where should you locate them so that you have the minimum response time for the most effective, you know, response. So to answer, but how do we answer these kinds of questions in a scientific, systematic way? So that is kind of the meta question in some sense. Then kind of a related aspect is actually to help answer these questions, you kind of need to know kind of a state of the various transportation related assets. Both in a continuously as well as in real time. Things like the status of roads, you know, for example, as mentioned, made of potholes, you know, status of pavements, stops, public buses, you know, traffic lights, you know, all kinds of things. So this is also kind of an interesting question to try to answer that, and we'll kind of just in the next slide, I'll kind of mention something about it. Another thing which we were discussing yesterday, not today, but I just captured it at the last minute, thanks to Kriti, was, you know, government has mandated that there will be electric vehicles by 2030. What is going to be the impact of that, both for the transport network as well as the electric grid? And then, of course, autonomous vehicles, right? I mean, how will that change the mobility? So now to answer these questions, there are certain critical elements which are required, and the first most critical element is data for all, you know, from all different categories. For example, we need data to, you know, of travel demand, what the transportation engineers call OD matrix, data of land use, we need data about the traffic parameters, volumes, density, vehicle types, driver behavior. Road network maps, you know, right now you have maps in Google, but you need probably much more detailed maps about the roads, the widths, where the traffic signals are, where bridges are, underpasses, etc., etc. So, and also you need to have these multi-scale models which are to be kind of created, which really digest the data and kind of, you know, capture the understanding in some sense. You know, these models capture demand, behavior, traffic patterns, many other things. And these are models which are at multi-scale, both temporal, spatial, you know, at different levels of granularity and accuracy. So what we are hoping is that if we can undertake this particular activity, we'll have some concrete outcomes. You know, one is actually related to tools and techniques to extract mobility-related information from existing data sources. We said we have data, we need data, but there's already a lot of data available. How do you kind of extract information, and, you know, which is of relevance to, you know, undertaking studies in this traffic? So, for example, data from traffic cameras. You have to have analytics to extract vehicle counts, tracking vehicles, things like that. You have user-generated content in terms of Twitters and app-based things that people are contributing information. You have Microsoft is doing vehicle-mounted sensors. So all kinds of data is coming. Being able to kind of somehow digest that and make it available upstream to others to use. We also heard this talk earlier about extracting landmarks or features. You know, how do you kind of annotate these kind of road network maps with these features which are extracted from data, both real time and static information. And then if you have these maps, then they become useful for downstream apps to actually use and provide other services. Models and simulation frameworks for Indian conditions. We also heard earlier in the talks today about how the existing simulators like Sumo, etc., are not really tuned for Indian conditions. And so that is a very critical need in some sense. It's not that you need to develop the simulation tools from scratch. It could just be probably adapting them and having the right models to put in there. And these models should capture the driver behaviors in Indian condition, the road conditions, especially the autos, two-wheelers, etc. And one could kind of look at doing this exercise perhaps at different granularities, take a specific ward perhaps, which is a smaller area, which is more tractable, and eventually scale it to the entire cities. And of course, all of this should lead to certain solution strategies to deal with the woes we have, which probably can be tested out on these models. Maybe we will not be able to try it out right away, but if you test it out on the models and tell it to the concerned authorities, hopefully these can be implemented. So my colleagues in that group, just pitch in and add anything else if I may have missed.
AI for both creating the data as well as for then modeling. I'm just also wondering whether, in terms of traffic cameras, has there anyone else worked on those areas? Because, some of my people are working on that, find it very difficult to adapt the existing because of the amount of packing that we have in our countries. You can't discern vehicles from one to another. I know it's not a question.
Actually, not just traffic cameras, everything, there's a lot of work which is ongoing. I mean, it's not to say that this is all new stuff that needs to be done. I think we have to build on what is already there so that we can reuse and so on. For traffic cameras, there are companies there's a company from IIT Delhi, startup from IIT Delhi, which is actually providing analytics for extracting vehicle counts based on different classes of vehicles and things like that.
Government department or regional government or anything that's trying to make use of mobile data? So for example, I know here in Bangalore, so Ashwin Mahesh gets VLR data, right? But then from the other side, because he has ties with government, he was able to get them permission to put base stations at various intersections so he can pull the data. So there's that, maybe that's a thing that one needs to pursue, those kind of partnerships.
Exactly. I agree.